In this animation, we'll be talking about print contexts. The information that you'll see in this animation applies both to creating a new print template or adding a print context to an existing template of web or email contexts. So let's start by creating a new print template. You can do this in two different ways, either using the welcome screen, clicking on Create Template, and then Print, or you could use the File New dialog, which has the information in a bit of a tree view instead of the more familiar wizard. When you first create a new print template or you add a print context to an existing template, the dialog that is shown is for the size of the media where you want to create your output. This can be changed later, but it's kind of easier to set it up right now, such as using letter or legal or whatever, than to do it later and change everything. Note that the margins at the bottom determine the margin of the whole template, meaning if you have a default margin on your printer, this option should match. When you add the new print context, the first thing that you can notice is that a blue border will surround the printable area. Basically, what's outside of the blue border is determined by the margins set in the new print context wizard. Another thing you might notice is that at the top, there is a display indicating what page you're on, what sheet you're on, and what masters and medias the current page is using. When you're doing overflow, this will change to reflect what that page is actually going to print on. Now let's explain medias and master pages. The media basically determines what kind of paper or what kind of media you will be printing on in the output. What you're trying to specify here is your intent or the intended media where it should be printed. Meaning, if you change the characteristics at the bottom, such as the media type or the coding, the output module will try to determine on the printer which one corresponds to the options that you've specified. If you're using pre-printed media, you have to check the background images option at the top and then specify a PDF or image file that will show in the background while you're actually designing your template. When you generate print output, the background images are not shown because it's assumed that they are on the pre-printed media inside the printer. So it's a design helper. The next thing that is important to understand is the concept of master pages. A master page is kind of like a layer in the sense that any element that you put on the master page will actually appear on every single one of your printed page. If you have only one master, then the same data or the same master page is printed on every single one of them. If you have more than one master, you can select which one will be printed on which position. The first thing we want to do is to actually edit the master to add some contents. Let's do that now, simply by double-clicking on it. Now, as you can see, the master page editor looks kind of like the main editor in the sense that you have your cursor and you can add any contents to it. Now, because the master page is often used to add something like a header or a footer, one thing that's important is that you can use the master page properties to define what area inside the master page will be non-contents, meaning where contents will not appear and you have only the static information inside of your master page. Let me go in the properties, and I'll add a larger header margin, such as 30 millimeters. So this is the area where you have the header of your page, kind of like the header and footer concept in Microsoft Word. So let's say I add some text, like a big header at the top. Now, when I do this and I go back to my print context, we can see that the data appears here. We can't click on it and edit it because it is part of a master, but we can add information inside of the body of the page. So this is a header, appears on every single page. Inside of master pages, you can actually have variable data. Let me add another position box. And we can add something like the page X of N, meaning page 1 of 2, 1 of 3, 2 of 3, etc. So when we go into preview mode, the information in the header page, page 1 of 1, will appear and will change depending on how many pages you have in each of your documents. Another important note is that you can actually have data from your record inside of the master page. So you can put something like a customer ID or an invoice ID directly in the header. That's perfectly functional. So I've loaded a data mapping configuration. And if I go back in the master page and add the customer ID, when we go back inside of the section editing in preview mode, we can see that indeed the variable data does work. Another thing that you can do with master pages is to add a background image. Let me import an image into the template. And then if I put this image directly into my master page, it will appear on every single page as a background. Let me just reorder my things here so they appear on top. So I've rearranged the elements a little bit. Normally when creating the master page, you would start by adding the image and then the other elements on top. Now going back to the print section, then we have the actual contents again with the PDF as a background. Now, to the contrary of the background media set inside of the media property, this PDF will print when you generate output. Now, as I mentioned previously, you can have more than one master page. You can simply create one by right-clicking and clicking on New Master. So let's say in this second master page, we want to add a footer. Well, since I changed the margin at the bottom for the footer, then we can directly add some data here. Now, because the main master page is master one, I still have the header here, not the footer. If you want to determine what master page appears in what position inside of your output, you need to set it in the section properties, and we'll take a look at that in the following animation.